Hello everyone and welcome to this video about how to use crimp terminals. There are many different types of terminals available, but they all share the same purpose. They allow you to connect and to disconnect one cable's end to another cable's end. They are very commonly used in the automotive sector, but of course also for many other industries. Home users use them quite often for audio appliances, for instance to extend or to shorten speaker cables. The first thing you have to do is to remove the cable insulation to uncover the single wire. The easiest and safest way to do that is by using a cable stripper. If you don't have one around, you could also use a box knife. I will show you both ways here. If you use a knife, be very gentle and cut one side after another, each until you feel that you've reached the single wires. You can basically tell by feeling that the metal of the blade hits the metal of the wire. Once you've cut all around the insulation, use pliers to carefully strip off the insulation. The uncovered part should, in this case for such a diameter of a cable, have a length of around 5 mm. Repeat the same for the other cable's end. As you can see, a wire stripper is way more comfortable, safer and quicker, so it's highly recommended to use one. Now that you have the free wires of both your cable ends, you are able to determine the required size of the terminals. Now that we know the size, we can choose a type. We need one male plug and a corresponding female socket. I will use a bullet disconnector here. This is the male plug and this is the female socket for it. Both the terminals now have to be crimped around the uncovered wires, which means that we are going to press the terminal around it. There are special crimp tools available that make sure that the terminal will be pressed with just the right force to neither damage the wires nor to have a loose terminal. Put the terminal over the wires so the stripped wires have contact to the conductive metal of the terminal. Do not twist the wires because this will change the cross section and may damage them. Best is to just make sure that they are all straight. Use the correct color index profile of the crimp pliers and press it firm. If you use an automatic plier like this one, it will lock itself until you've applied sufficient force. When crimped, check the connection by pulling on the terminal to make sure that it sits tightly and doesn't come off. Now I'm going to repeat this process for the other cable end, but of course with the female socket terminal. Again, pull the terminal over the wires and in position, take the crimping pliers and use the correct color index profile to firmly press the terminal around the wires. This time I'm using manual crimp pliers. It's not a big difference, just make sure to press hard enough but not too hard because you don't want to damage the wires. It's not very complicated though, so you'll probably get it right in the first try. That's it. Both the terminals can now be connected and disconnected as required. So, as you can see, it's really not that difficult, especially with the right tool. I hope this video has helped you to understand the purpose of terminals and how to apply them. If so, we will appreciate your like, and in case that anything was unclear, just leave us a comment and we will try to answer it for you. And last but not least, again the information that this video was brought to you by the WKK Group, the European B2B supplier for fixation materials. If your business needs fixation materials like cable ties, heat shrink tubing, terminals or other products of this kind, check out wkk-europe.com. Thanks for watching and have a good day.